ultimate driving machine.
Well, I can't believe this. We're over 2 hours into the show, and Graceland has not won anything. This is like... it's amazing. Not too long ago, heavy metal was confined to the underground, but times change, and the Grammys change with the times. And we acknowledge the art form that is keeping the rebellious essence of rock and roll alive, and have added a Grammy Award in that category for the first time this year. So here to perform the song One from the Grammy-nominated album, And Justice for All, Metallica.
Thank you.
Zapisa na your bed. Can you pass it in your head?
Couldn't they give us a few more minutes after that? Anyway, let's get on with it. Thank you. You want a job? let's see. I think the first thing we got to do is, obviously, like you guys were expecting, is we got to thank Jethro Tull for not putting out an album this year, right? And also, obviously, we got to thank the Academy for giving Jethro Tull the award in 1989. Read between the lines, know what I mean? Just kidding, guys. Just kidding. Thanks a lot for, I want to thank all those stations for coming around finally and understanding what the hell Metallica was all about. And then obviously, which is the most important, yeah, I know, get on with it, right, is that I want to thank all the thousands or millions of Metallica fans out there who've been following us for 10, 11 years now and who've made all this possible and proving to everybody out there in the industry and so on that if you stick to your gut and just do what you want to do, that, you know, all this will happen sooner or later and people will wake up, you know what I mean? So thanks a lot. Okay.
you think so? I'm gonna get it on with a song about truth within. It's the happy tune entitled Sad But True. We'll be right back.
Thank you. nothing else matters.
We'd all like to thank you and Queen for letting us play here. Thank you very much. We'll see you.
All right, what a way to get into the Concert for Life. That is Metallica, and you Metallica fans, listen up. James Hetfield, later on tonight, is going to be doing a Queen song, one of his favorites, Stone Cold Crazy, backed up by Queen.
I know it's hard to play before 72,000 people, but what's it like to open a show like that?
Nerve-wracking, yeah, no doubt. Especially when they're, I think they wanted to hear Queen songs right away. So.
Oh, that was bad.
No, it was fine, you know.
Is it a good crowd out there?
Yeah, I mean, they're here to have a good time and hear a lot of Queen stuff. And
you're gonna be back a little bit later,
yeah,
right?
I will. That'll be a lot of fun.
Are you ready for this?
Sure, absolutely. No doubt.
Okay. Where do you guys go from here?
We have a nice long break for about 2 weeks.
Yeah.
We're gonna be in the Bay Area, just hanging out.
So if anybody wants to find you, they could.
No one's gonna find us.
Wait.
No one.
We're hidden.
Absolutely.
You sticking around for any of the other acts that are playing here today?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sticking around for his big act.
Yeah, well, yeah.
They're going to start a pit out there.
Yeah. I'm going to be his manager.
It could be some a solo act of some sort. You know, you could keep this going.
My new band. Oh, yeah, I forgot to tell you guys.
Okay, well, congratulations on your triumphant opening here. It was really great.
And now,
back to you.
Thanks.
Their current album has been on the charts for 75 weeks. It has sold 6.5 million copies. A winner tonight. Please welcome James, Lars, Kirk, and Jason. Metallica.
We'll be right back.
said.
Turn off your hearing aids, teenagers. It's Metallica.
Where do I take this pain of mine? I run, but it stays right by my side. Open for me out. There's things inside that scream and shout. And the pain still hates me. So hold it, I'm serious. Just like the curse, just like the story.
Thank you. she has taught me well, told me when I was young. Son, your life's an open book, don't close it till it's done. The brightest flame burns quickest, that's what I heard her say. My son's heart told to mother that I must find my way. Let my heart go, let your son grow. Mama, let my heart go, or let this heart be still, yes, still. My new last name, white blood in my veins, apron strings around my neck, the mark that still remains. Left home at an early age, what I heard was wrong. Never ask forgiveness, what is said is done. Let my heart go, let your son grow. Mama, let my heart go, or let this heart be still. Never I ask of you, but never I give. You gave me your emptiness, I now take to my grave. Never I ask of you, but never I give. You gave me your emptiness, I now take to my grave. So let this heart be still. Coming home, I'm not all you wish to be, but a mother's love for her son spoken, help me be. Oh yeah, I took your love for granted, all the things you said to me. Yeah, need your arms to welcome me, the cold stone's all I see.
We'll be right back. morceau qu'on va entendre est également diffusé en simultané sur Fun Radio. Non, finalement, on va attendre, on va d'abord les écouter. On va écouter Fuel.
I guess we ain't got to get into all them little corny your mama jokes and all of that. We gonna get straight to the category.
I think so. Shall we just tell them who the rock and roll artist of the year is?
No doubt. For Collective Soul, my label mates, Metallica.
How about Wallflowers? How about Aerosmith? Are you ready?
No doubt. The artist of the year goes to my label mates, Metallica!
Run, the door is locked now.
open if you're true, if you can understand the me, I can understand the you. Lay beside me sky, through black of day, dark of night, we share this paradise. The door cracks open, but there's no sun shining through. Black heart scarring like a steel, but there's no sun shining through. No, there's no sun shining through.
Please welcome platinum recording artist Meredith Brooks and Ralph Lauren's man.
Extravaganza is being brought to you by Triple J and Recovery. Here now to chat to the band, we have the Triple J metal expert, Mr. Costa Zulio. Thanks, Dylan. How are you going, guys?
We're good.
Welcome.
All right,
to...
shut up. Shut up!
Lars is in charge.
Okay.
How did Unforgiven 2 come about, considering it's your latest single out at the moment?
The song or the video?
The song.
Basically, it was just us wanting to try and do something we'd never done, which is continue a story. There was never like the first part of it wasn't complete or anything. It was just the music, when me and James were writing, it kind of reminded us of the first song, and we thought it would be kind of fun to try and just continue the story with the same characters. And that's pretty much what we did.
With Lomaine's lyric, that was the first time you actually had other musicians in the studio. What was that like?
There's been extra players on Metallica records before. Different, actually, the same guys for the percussion, those kind of things. And there have been like symphony orchestras and so forth. But the hurdy-gurdy guy, that was something special. One guy that happened to be from San Francisco, and I guess James had the initial idea that to have more of a minstrel jam kind of vibe to it. And it's the only song on Reload that we actually sat all together in a room in a circle like this, with Lars had like a drum set with lots of tambourines and shakers and all kind of different stuff to hit. James had a guitar, like $35 Sears guitar, you know, and I had a cheap bass, and Kirk had some other different kind of instrument to make a very different twangy kind of weirdness to it, you know, and everybody with that vibe sitting in a circle.
A couple of years down the track now from Load, and you're saying you're saying that the fans are being more accepting. Do you think that's because you've brought a record out like Load and Reload?
Maybe. I think what happens is that any time a band like us shake the foundations up a little bit, there's always a lot of people who are initially kind of unsure about what that really means in the long run. And I think what happened when Load came out, there were some people that seriously thought that we'd lost our minds. And then when we came and toured all over the place for a year and a half, and they could see that once we got up and played in front of them, that real strength of what Metallica always had been was still there, just updated or, you know, just going through another metamorphosis, but still was really there at heart. I think a lot of people really, I think, found new respect for it, and I think that's continuously happening as we go and play.
It might have taken them a while, that's the thing. It might have taken them a while for it to set in, but I think the respect is still there because of our taking chances, and people look to Metallica to do that kind of thing and always be breaking down, you know, new barriers and that kind of stuff, and that's, I mean, we look to us more than anybody else to do that same thing, so.
Okay. All right, thanks a lot, guys. All right. We're going to throw open some questions into the crowd now to speak directly to the band. I'm looking for Brian. Oh, Brian. Brian is our competition winner. He's been following Metallica around everywhere, a little bit obsessive, perhaps.
Just a little bit, yeah.
Have you got a question for Metallica?
Yeah, I was just wondering, you haven't played Unforgiven 2 yet on the tour. No. I was just wondering why you haven't, seeing especially when it's the current, well, it was the first single released over here. And when should we be expecting to hear it?
Yeah, Lars, how come we're not playing that?
Haven't figured out how to sing it yet.
We haven't really figured it out yet, to be honest. One of the only songs we ever tackled live was on the Black Album tour that we weren't that comfortable playing was the first Unforgiven, and it never really settled in properly. We tried playing Unforgiven 2 at a TV show in Las Vegas in December, and that wasn't our strongest moment.
And, good way to put it.
So we might bring it out for the summer in America. At the same time, as you know, since you've seen us a bunch, is that we don't like to go out. Now we're touring Reload. We don't go out and play, you know, 90% of Reload. I really like to balance it with all the albums. So but we're playing 3 or 4 songs from the new album, and maybe we'll play Unforgiven 2 next time we come down.
The Vic Comp runner-up. This is Stephen Norris. Well done, Stephen. Have you got a question?
Yes. I was just wondering, what is your favorite riff?
Riff?
Riff, man. One riff, you know, just riff. Just each time you just go, just want to blow up.
There's so many. Probably the first one in No Remorse.
Go and sing it.
That's a good time.
That one, yeah.
That one's cool. That one rocks. I like, I think the middle of Master of Puppets when it goes.
Doing the punch.
Nicholas, where do you see the future of the metal heavy rock genre at the moment?
I think that there's a lot of, you know, with electronic music coming on and a lot of the fast beats and that, a lot of people have been drawn to that because of its energy and aggression and that kind of thing. But nothing will ever replace the 4 or 5 guys playing guitars really loud and that kind of stuff. So that's it's always a B, no matter how far it goes underground before it rears its head again. You know, whatever, it's always going to be there underlying. Like, look at all these people here that are still way into that kind of music. It may not be the popular music that's being played on the radio or on the video or whatever, but it still lives, you know, in us and a lot of people. So it's always there.
Will you be really old guys rocking one day?
We already are old guys.
Speak for yourself.
How many more years can we expect Metallica to rock on?
Forever and ever.
Yes, sir.
And now from the grooviest show up.
Well, 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 well. The show is running 10 minutes over, so we've been
we've been severely shortened, so I'm supposed to just say, very simply, the artist of the year is considered the best of the best.
Here are the four finalists.
And the video montage has been cut too, so the four finalists are the Backstreet Boys,
TLC,
Ricky Martin,
Britney Spears.
The Billboard Music Award Artist of the Year is...
Oh my God.
Us. See ya. All right. The cute and sexy Backstreet Boys.
Check it out.
check it out. Metallica is the fiercest band on earth, man. And tonight you've told them what to do. That's right. They're going to play the song that you ordered, dude. Tell Metallica what to do. Play the damn song, Metallica. Yeah! We'll be right back. two performances coming up. They got a six-pack between them and seven tattoos. We got Christina Aguilera with her ABC show on Sunday. And we got Mark McGrath.
Number four, Metallica versus Napster. And because this is a serious issue, we're going to give it the respect it deserves with a point, counterpoint. Point.
I believe this is about the artist's right to his own product. He should be paid for his own product, should not have it stolen from him. Blood, sweat, and tears went into that product, and it is his.
Counterpoint.
Dude, the music's free! Yeah!
Thank you very much.
And
here's your nominees for Best Stage Spectacle.
Best Stage Spectacle. Metallica. Red Hot Chili Peppers. Britney Spears.
All right, the voting is closed. This is hurting my back. The best stage spectacle is...
Anybody?
The people.
We want to thank the people.
I'd like to thank my mom.
Hi, Mom.
And the symphony for having the balls to put up with Metallica, I must say. I think, but if we had have played the symphony show with just socks on, that would have been quite a spectacle.
I want to thank Twiggy Ramirez from Manson's band for letting me puke in his bathroom the other day, and then... kind of taking care of me afterwards, so thanks, Twiggy, wherever you are.
I'd also like to thank Michael Kamen and Bobby Urban. Without them, we wouldn't probably
And James Brett.
And James Brett. Without them, we probably wouldn't be here.
Yeah, that was one of the most, I'd think, intense and nerve-wracking moments of our career, to pretend like we were real musicians for a minute.
I'd like to also thank the harp player, because he was... full-on
okay,
metal.
Okay, let's get on with it. Oh, and thanks to John Sykes for putting all this together.
And the Metallica fans, baby!